बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अस्सलामुअलैकुम दिस इज मोहम्मद अबुल हुसैन सरकार असिस्टेंट हेड टीचर भवेरचर रजौली हाई स्कूल गजरिया मुंशीगंज। डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू माय ऑनलाइन क्लास। दिस क्लास इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9 and 10। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेरी वेल एंड गुड बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ ऑलमाइटी अल्लाह। अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, आई एम ऑल्सो फाइन। Dear students, today our subject is English writing part. Dear students and viewers, today our topic is paragraph. At first, we should know the definition of paragraph, or what is the definition of a paragraph. Dear learners and viewers, we can simply say paragraph is a collection of sentences or relative sentences dealing with only one topic. Dear students, I repeat, paragraph is a collection of sentences or related sentences dealing with only one topic. Clear? Dear learners and viewers, now we should know the different parts of paragraphs. Dear students, how many parts are there in a paragraph? The answer is, there are 3 parts in a paragraph. Number 1, introduction. Number 2, body. Number 3, conclusion. Dear students, how many parts are there in a paragraph? There are 3 parts in a paragraph. Number 1, introduction. Number 2, body. And number 3, conclusion. These are the 3 parts of a paragraph. Clear? Dear students, at first, we should know regarding introduction. Introduction is the first part of a paragraph. This part is very important because the topic sentence and controlling idea introduces this part. So, this part is very important for writing a paragraph. Dear students, the introduction is the most important part for writing a paragraph. Number 2, body. Dear students, body is the second part of a paragraph. It is the most important part for writing a paragraph. This part analyzes, discusses, and discussion the main idea, main theme of a paragraph. This part also analyzes and discusses and discussions the main theme of a paragraph, the controlling idea of a paragraph. So this part is very important for writing a paragraph. Dear students, next, conclusion. Conclusion is the third or last part for writing a paragraph. This part is very important for writing a paragraph. Conclusion summarizes the controlling idea. I repeat, conclusion summarizes the controlling idea. Dear students, all the three parts, number one, introduction, number two, body, and number three, conclusion. All these three parts are very important for writing a paragraph. So we can say that introduction, body, and conclusion, all these three parts are very important for writing a paragraph. Clear? Dear students and learners, we have to know what are the parts of a paragraph. We should know the different parts of a paragraph. The answer is, there are three parts of a paragraph: introduction, body, conclusion. I discussed all the parts very well for the betterment of you. Dear students and learners, we should know the different parts of paragraph. Dear students and learners, how to write a paragraph in a proper way? Dear learners and viewers, how to write a paragraph properly? Number one, only one topic, oblique idea. You have to remember that. You have to write a paragraph by using only one topic, oblique idea. This part is very important for writing a paragraph. The topic idea, the topic introduces the main theme of a paragraph. Number two, only one para. Dear learners and viewers, only one para means para should not be allowed for writing a paragraph. Dear students, I repeat, only one para means para should not be allowed for writing a paragraph. You have to write your paragraph only one para. Number three, a logical title. Dear students, you have to write a logical title for writing a paragraph. Number four, topic sentence. Dear viewers and learners, topic sentence is the most important for writing a paragraph. Generally, a paragraph introduces the main theme or logical ideas in the topic sentence. Suppose we have to write a paragraph on computer. What should be the topic sentence? What may be the topic sentence? Dear learners and viewers, computer, the topic sentence may be, computer is one of the most wonderful inventions of modern science. This is the focus sentence, this is the main sentence of a paragraph. This is called topic sentence. So we can say that topic sentence is very important for writing a suitable paragraph. Number 5, logical sequence of thought or development. Dear students, you have to write by using logical sequence of thought or development for writing a suitable paragraph. Number 6, a suitable concluding sentence. Concluding sentence, this is the last sentence of a paragraph. A suitable concluding sentence is situated in the third part, in the third portion, last portion of a paragraph, that is conclusion. A suitable concluding sentence is also important for writing a paragraph. Number 7, about 100 to 120 words. Dear students and viewers, you have to write your paragraph about 100 to 120 words. Dear students, I repeat, you have to write your paragraph by using about 100 to 120 words. Number 8, British or American style. Dear students, you should bear in mind that you can write your paragraph both British or American style. American style means modern style. Number 9, vocabulary. Vocabulary is very important for writing part. Dear learners and viewers, you should enrich your vocabulary for writing a paragraph. Dear students and learners, you have to bear in mind that you have to face in the exam question paragraph. You have to answer these paragraphs by answering these questions. Dear students and learners, you have to have vocabulary for writing a standard paragraph. Dear students and learners, remember that cramming is no good. It is not a wise policy. But it is a matter of great regret that most of the students of our secondary level are very expert in memorizing answers. But it is a matter of great regret that in this way you may become a parrot. You may remember, you may learn anything within a short time, but you cannot remember it for a long time. Dear students and learners, so I would like to advise you, without thinking, without understanding, without gazing, you should not learn anything. But it is a matter of great regret that most of the students of our country, they do not think about writing anything. So I request you, if you want to develop your writing skills, if you want to develop your thinking power, if you want to develop your writing capacity, you have to enrich your vocabulary. Dear students and learners, you have to remember that writing skill is
very important for you, because if you want to get good marks in English, you have to do well in the writing part. So I would request you, for developing your writing part, you have to enrich your vocabulary, you have to enrich your writing capacity. If you follow this practice, if you follow these rules, it would be possible for you for developing your writing skill. Dear students and learners, today I am going to finish my lecture. No more today. Thank you very much, everybody. Goodbye. See you in the next class.